Allow me to introduce myself. My name, as reflects my humble origins, is Mr. William Smith, engineer and mineral surveyor. For the past 24 years, whether in a professional capacity or at my own expense, I have travelled the length and breadth of much of England and a good part of Wales. And in all of these wanderings, I have pursued one great purpose, and that has been to identify and to map out the different geological strata that make up this island of Britain. It is a task, I think, never before accomplished upon such a scale. It all began in 1791, when I was employed to survey the coal workings at High Littleton, near Bath in Somersetshire. It was there that I first appreciated the order and the regularity of the strata lying above the coal veins. Always above the coal, there was the red earth or marl, and above that, the blue lias limestone, and so forth. And these strata all appeared to be inclined in the same direction, and were stacked one upon the other, like so. Later, when I became engineer and surveyor for the Somersetshire Coal Canal Company in 1794, I found further proofs of this regularity by observing the strata that were laid bare in cutting canals across a large tract of country. I was but a young man in my early 20s then, and since then I have uncovered many more strata, as you may see from the map behind me. Yet I could not have accomplished this had it not been for one important discovery. I knew that many of these strata had long ago formed the bed of the sea, for they contain the fossil remains of sea creatures like nothing now living, such as this beautiful ammonite, which the country folk call a snake stone. I found that each stratum of rock had its own distinct assemblage of fossils, by which it could be characterised and distinguished from other strata. And this knowledge enables me to distinguish different strata, or the same strata, in different parts of the country, whether it be the south coast of Dorsetshire or the northeast coast of Yorkshire. Now, with such a map as you see here, it is possible to predict where strata of coal, iron ore, limestone, sandstone or clay may be discovered. No longer need immense sums of money be imprudently and wastefully expended in looking for coal and other minerals in places where there is no prospect of them being found. The colours that I have chosen for my map reflect in some degree the natural colour of each stratum of rock, excepting the chalk, which, being white, I thought best to indicate in green, like the grassy sward of our English downland. And as further example, the oolitic limestone, from which we obtain our finest building stones, I have shown in yellow, much like the colour of this ammonite, which comes out of the same stratum of rock. The lowest part of each stratum I have given a darker shade of colour to enable you to distinguish its base from its top. I think I can state with some pride that my map of the strata of England and Wales, of which you see here but a small part, encompasses the most detailed geological survey of this island.